the blood supply because the head of femur is peculiar to its blood supply. It's also called as Chandler's disease or osteochondritis of femoral head. See, there's also a term where we call it a silent hip only in case of AVN. A patient usually will present with the pain in one hip. On subject to investigation, able to notice the radiological changes in the second hip on MRI evaluation. So that's why it's also called as silent hip. So the rate and course of this AVN is unpredictable because a patient with a stage 2 will be asymptomatic or even in stage 2B. But whereas in some patients with stage 1, they'll have severe pain and limp. In 50% of the cases, it's bilateral and it's due to idiopathic. And for historical review, first in 1738, Monroe, in his study, described about avascular necrosis, and subsequently in 1888, Koenig coined the term as osteochondritis dissecans of femoral head, and later in 1925, Hanisch described the first case of idiopathic avascular necrosis, and later in a pilot study, it was found that the etiology was due to arterial occlusion, and after 8 years after that, Chandler was the one who told us it's a coronary disease of hip following the obstruction of the blood supply to the femoral head. And 1957, the Pietrograndi identified the first case of AVN following steroid therapy. Initially, aseptic necrosis was used. Of late, now the avascular necrosis or ischemic necrosis is the common terminology we use it. It's more neutral in its cause because the main feature of this is the death of the bone cell. See, before going in detail to the avascular necrosis, I want to enumerate the blood supply to the femoral head. So this is the Crux extracapsular arterial ring present at the base of the femoral neck. Posteriorly, you have the medial circumflex femoral vessel and anteriorly by the lateral circumflex femoral vessel. And later there are ascending cervical branches and retinacular vessels on the surface of the neck. This retinacular vessels is in close proximity and which run parallel along the neck. So that is why it's more involved or it's usually torn following any injury. And proximally you have the artery of ligamentum teres. So the main blood supply is present only at the base of the neck, this extracapsular arterial ring. The anatomical risk factors is because the subchondral bone lies at a distance from the main vascular territory, that is from away from the neck. And also the subchondral trabeculae is supplied only by the end arterioles. And also the vascular sinusoids do not have the adventitial layer. So when there is an increase in the bone marrow pressure, intramedullary pressure, it causes bone marrow edema, and so there's a death of bone cell. So this you need to remember for your lifetime. So I've worked out this for the causes of the avascular necrosis. It can be traumatic or non-traumatic, traumatic and traumatic causes. So either you can remember from A to T or a mnemonic. Alcohol, coagulation disorders, either protein C or S deficiency, DIC, antithrombin 3 deficiency, decompression sickness or Caisson's disease, diabetes, drugs, usually very common, steroids, chemotherapy drugs, estrogens, gout, HIV, hyperlipidemia, idiopathic and infection. Idiopathic is the most common. Pancreatitis, pregnancy, renal osteodystrophy, radiation, smoking, SLE, solid organ transplantation, It includes also bone marrow transplantation, sickle cell anemia, thrombophilia, and trauma. So you remember this mnemonic, the RAD HIP Gates. So trauma, HIV, estrogen, renal osteodystrophy, radiation, alcohol, and 4 Ds. So decompression disease, diabetes, drug induced, and DIC, HIV, hyperlipidemia, infection, idiopathic, P2, pancreatitis, and pregnancy, G for gout, T for again trauma, E estrogen, S for smoking, SLE, solid organ transplantation, and sickle cell anemia. This you need to remember either this way or the mnemonic. So coming to epidemiology, 10 to 25% of hip dislocation at increased risk. Patient presenting as early, the chances of AVN is less. Presenting late, the chances are more. In non-displaced femoral neck fractures, there are 10% chances. And displaced femoral neck fractures, there are 15 to 50% risk is there. And in atraumatic AVN, due to idiopathic cause, there are about 5 to 18% of THR performed in US has been noted. And male-female ratio of 4:1. Mean age of presentation is 38 years. Usually it's asymmetrical and bilateral involvement is in about 30 to 70%, but approximately around 50%. So you need to remember the 4 main etiological factors. In simple, need to remember the artery, arterioles, capillaries, vein. So interruption of arterial flow, intravascular blockade of arterioles and capillary due to increase in bone marrow pressure producing capillary compression, and occlusion of venous flow. These are the 4 etiological factors. So for every etiological factors, the causes has been linked. So for arterial occlusion in case of fracture neck of femur, case of dislocation hip, slipped capital femoral epiphysis, infection, frog leg immobilization in case of Perthes. When you come to arterial occlusion, it can be sickle cell disease, SLE, Haysen's disease, hemostatic disorders, and gout. And in capillary compression, it is Gaucher's disease and fatty infiltration, where the fat emboli causes occlusion of the vessel. Seen in usage of steroid patients, alcohol abuse, familial hyperlipidemia, and renal transplant, and in case of hyperbaric conditions, Haysen's disease. So this viscous cycle must be remembered. Either way of one involved, the chances of AVN is high. So it can start with arterial occlusion, resulting in increase in bone marrow pressure, producing marrow edema, causing sinusoidal compression and vascular stasis, and resulting in AVN. Or it can start with a sinusoidal compression, because these cases like Gaucher's, TB, steroid therapy, and alcohol, producing fat emboli, causing sinusoidal compression, producing vascular stasis, arterial occlusion, marrow edema. So this is a cycle. So sickle cell disease, dyspareic ischemia, produces arterial occlusion. So this viscous cycle responsible for causing AVN. So how do you link the avascular necrosis and causes of steroids? But the main pathogenesis of steroid, the patient using steroids and developing AVN is unknown, because all the patients taking steroids don't get AVN. Only those who are on peak doses of steroids are significant than the duration, because we treat a lot of rheumatoid arthritis patient long duration of steroid therapy, we don't encounter any case of AVN. But those with neurological disorders on steroid therapy, because they're given high dosage of steroids. So what happens, this fat emboli from the liver or from the bone marrow cells, they become destabilized, and this plasma lipoproteins may be responsible. This is one study. The other thing is the corticosteroid associated with insulin resistance causing hypertension, where there is the intimal thinning, thickening and producing arteriosclerosis and so called as the coronary disease of hip, or long term steroid therapy, initial producing osteoporosis in elderly age group, producing microfractures and AVN. Associated with renal failure, it's a complication of treatment where the recombinant growth hormone is used for renal disease. In SLE, there's a thickening and necrosis of the basement membrane leading to the vessel occlusion. So you must remember that viscous cycle. Arterial occlusion, marrow edema, sinusoidal compression, and venous stasis. How do you link alcohol? Same. The fat emboli that originate from the fatty liver. The femoral head is the most common location for AVN to occur. And pancreatitis is also linked to chronic alcoholism due to fat emboli, also can cause AVN. In case of sickle cell disease and thalassemia, the change in the shape of the cell, the sluggish flow of the sickle shaped cell, results in diminished blood flow causing AVN. With irradiation, it can produce, the radiotherapy can produce a direct cell damage, damage to the vessel wall causing obliteration of the vessel, seen in Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's patients receiving radiotherapy and chemotherapy, and those who are already compromised on steroids. And this is very commonly encountered in case of trauma. There's a dislocation of hip or a fractured neck of femur, treated or untreated, chances of AVN is there. Not in all the patients. It depends on damage to the retinocular vessels, because the retinocular vessels present, as I told you already, present in the neck, it's usually torn or stretched along the surface of the neck of femur. And also the high pressure following any trauma, there's a blood collected inside the capsule, producing a tamponade effect, and so it results in the death of the bone cell. In case of decompression sickness, dyspareic, the undersea water divers, there's increase in the intramedullary bone pressure. For these patients, there's a radiographic changes encountered is usually more than up to 4 to 12 months. For these conditions, the lesions are usually encountered adjacent to the joint surface. AVN and Gaucher's disease, the glucose precursors in the reticuloendothelial cells, either it can produce a liver disease or it can have a direct affection of the femoral head. The reticuloendothelial cells get causing obstruction of the arterial circulation or producing a fat emboli from the liver, producing AVN. And idiopathic avascular necrosis, if all the causes has been of the AVN has been excluded, we put it as idiopathic, because no history of steroids or any other causes which we have discussed here is not fitting, then we take it as idiopathic avascular necrosis. It constitutes about 25% of cases, but the proper etiology has been not known. But there are few studies that the thrombosis of the vessel supplying the femoral head may be a cause. And there may be diffuse osteoporosis with loss of trabeculae, which is surrounded by sclerosis, is seen in case of idiopathic AVN. There are 5 theories for the pathogenesis of AVN. So it can be a cell toxicity, direct injury to the cell, elevated bone marrow pressure, vascular obstruction, coagulopathic states, and fat emboli. But none can account for the cause of the AVN. So these risk factors never develop AVN, or patient without risk factors can also develop AVN. So that's why AVN is told as a multifactorial. So the pathogenesis is usually divided into 4 stages. In simple, it's if you want to remember, you take it as first is avascular, death of bone cell, revascularization phase, and repair phase, and deformity phase. So we will discuss one by one. So avascular phase, what happens? Due to disruption of blood supply, there is infarction. It occurs within the bone marrow, fatty marrow, adjacent to the subchondral bone, because the subchondral bone is very compromised to the blood supply. So what happens? Then next, the subchondral bones, as it's necrotic, the overlying cartilage near the subchondral bone tries to hypertrophy. So it is an attempt to convert the cartilage to the bone, but it couldn't make out, and that is why it appears as a minimal osteopenia and subtle soft tissue changes in this avascular phase. This you can make out as an increase in the medial joint space. That is called the Waldenstrom sign. See, this is a teardrop with a medial joint space of 2 millimeter difference in the left hip and the right hip. So this is the increase in the medial joint space. This is a Waldenstrom sign. And next is the revascularization phase. This phase is a balance between the osteoclast and osteoblastic activity. It shows mixed areas of lucency and sclerosis, because already there is a bone cell death. The dead cell is not able to withstand the normal stress. So it results in fragmentation and collapse of the overlying cortex in the subchondral area. And this is the first indication of collapse, which we tell it as a crescent sign. So crescent sign is seen in the revascularization phase. And this is the first sign which we see in X-ray. And subsequently, this crescent sign, after this minimal collapse in the subchondral region as a linear line, the further collapse may result in a step sign. I will tell you and discuss later. And next is the snow cap sign. It's a diffuse sclerosis of the femoral head. It's usually seen in periodic age group where the repair is sufficient. So there's a diffuse sclerosis of the whole of the femoral head. So this is the crescent sign. It's a thin curvilinear translucency which occurs beneath the subchondral region. It occurs in the weight-bearing part. Suppose if the patient keeps on weight-bearing, the further collapse occurs at the subchondral region, and it results in the step sign. Because in weight-bearing part, the collapse of the femoral head is inevitable. So keeps on weight-bearing, the crescent sign will end up in a step sign. So in brief, fracture occurring junction between the repaired and unrepaired part of neck, already a part of the bone death is there, necrotic bone is there. So the osteoblastic, osteoclastic activity, if it's maintained, the patient goes in for revascularization. Otherwise, there is a fibrocartilaginous tissue present at the interval. It appears as a radiolucent line and is shown as a crescent sign. As I told you, the snow cap sign usually is seen in the pediatric age group. Diffuse sclerosis of the femoral head, usually in the femoral head or the humeral head, seen in revascularization phase. Next stage is the revascularization. It all depends upon the amount of the osteoblastic activity, new bone cells, the bone cells form. The degree of the blood loss and the cell death is the initial. Already an insult has happened. If the patient immune system and healing is good, and the repair is good. If the immune system and healing is poor, and it can end up in the next phase, where it says deformity phase. And it also depends upon whether the bone is weight bearing or non weight bearing. When it's going to be a weight bearing, there is more stress on the subchondral region, and it end up in the deformed bone. It's going to be a non weight bearing. For example, in case of proximal humerus, it is a non weight bearing bone. So the revascularization is good compared to femoral head. And this is the final stage of pathogenesis, where the deformity phase. It purely depends upon the severity of other spaces. So weight-bearing area shows there is increased deformity in the weight-bearing surface. So there is incongruity in the joint surface, both in the femoral head and the acetabular region, ending up in osteoarthritis of the femoral head. The fortunate aspect of this process that is often treatable if discovered early, this deformity phase. So this, the pathosis is the third, the repair phase. It also ends up in 8 phases. Either the patient can go in for repair and can get a remodeled femoral head, or it can go in for a deformed femoral head. So this sequence of repair occurs in phase 1, less than 12 hours, there is loss of cell fiber, necrosis. And later, there can be chromatin pycnosis and karyolysis, chromatin condensation and dissolution of chromatin. And later, due to minute invasion of marrow spaces by capillaries and the already existing mesenchymal cells. In general, there is a small area of necrosis, and adjacent to that, there is a live bone. So what happened from the live bone, the new primitive mesenchymal cells try to infiltrate and try to regenerate the dead bone through the invasion of capillaries in the dead bone. So phase 4, so it causes new bone formation. So at the phase 5, early internal remodeling occurs, and later late internal remodeling occurs. So next comes the balance between the bone reabsorption and bone formation. If bone reabsorption is more and the deformity can persist. If bone reabsorption is less and bone formation is good, the patient can escape from the deformity. If bone reabsorption is more, there is a pannus formation, fibrillation, and destruction of the cartilage resulting in the secondary arthritis changes in the hip. This you need to know, the 4 zones of AVN. Usually it arises in the central, there are 4 zones. Zone A, this is central zone of cell death. And surrounding that area will be, this is the B, the zone of ischemic injury. So adjacent to the bone is the zone of active hyperemia. And normal tissue is present adjacent to it. So zone of central zone of death where there is the necrotic tissue is there, and zone of ischemic injury, hyperemic zone, and normal tissue. Histopathology, there's a small wedge-shaped area of necrosis in the subchondral bone, usually in the weight-bearing part, in the anterosuperior part. So there may be an invasion of the vascularized cellular tissue from the surrounding live bone. So this is the part. There may be invasion of vascularized cellular tissue and new bone get deposited, ensheathing the necrotic bone, and that's why it appears as increased radiological density. So that is why the cartilage directly over the necrotic bone is very dull in MRI, it's very dull, and peroperatively we see it's fibrillated and sometimes it may be fissured or discolored, and you can see deep cleft in the lateral aspect of femoral head near the acetabular roof. So this you need to remember. Excuse me. So the classification system. So each and every one need to know in detail about the classification system of avascular necrosis. This is the great legend, Dr. Paul Fickett, who gave us the Fickett and Allard's classification. ARCO classification. Association Research Osseous Committee. This classification system usually incorporates all staging, all classification systems described. And Fickett and Allard, we commonly use it. And the Japanese Investigation Committee, JIC classification system, Pennsylvania classification, and Shimizu classification, all based on bone scan, X-ray, MRI, biopsy. And this Tacori classification is purely based on the MRI finding. Fickett and Allick classification, you need to remember in simple. I've made it in simple based upon the stages, symptoms, and radiology, bone scan, pathology, and biopsy. In stage zero, usually it is normal, except in bone scan, we pick up a decreased uptake. It may or may not be. As this is asymptomatic. Stage 0 and 1 usually is asymptomatic. And stage 1, there may be increased uptake cold spot in bone scan. There is infarction seen in the weight bearing surface. And stage 2 is subdivided as 2A and 2B. It's a mild stage, clinically patient mild pain with the limitation of movement, and a small mild limp will be there. There's a sclerosis or subchondral cyst, increased uptake in the bone scan. This is the phase where the reparative zone can be seen, balance between the osteoblast and osteoclastic activity. That is why you can see a new bone in following a biopsy. If the osteoclastic activity is more, it can end up in the next stage where there is flattening of femoral crescent sign and subsequently flattening of the femoral head. And stage 3 is where there's increased collapse, increased uptake with subchondral fragmentation is seen associated with the fracture. You cannot see any new bone, only dead bones are seen. Stage 4 is degenerative stage where osteoarthritis changes have been encountered. Arcostaging, there are 7 stages. Usually stage 0 is asymptomatic. In stage 1, symptoms may or may not be there with the mild changes in the MRI. And stage 2, MRI is diagnostic. MRI finding is diagnostic. But in arcostaging, we see crescent sign here, it's in stage 3. There it was stage 2A, here's stage 3. 3A, it's less than 50% of articular involvement, and 15 to 30 is B, and more than 30 is C. And collapse of femoral head, because subsequently after crescent sign, you have the flattening of femoral head, the femoral head collapses. So based upon the involvement, is A less than 15, B 15 to 30, more than 30. So you see all the classification almost it's linked to each other. If you remember Fickett and Allett, you can fit in for all the stages except for this crescent sign is stage 3. And degenerative changes is seen in stage 5. An extensive destruction of joint and involved bone in case of stage 6 in Arcos system. And this is another classification is Japanese investigation committee Ozono classification. They describe it as 3 types, type 1, type 2 and type 3. Type 1 is subdivided based upon the band-like sclerosis, and type 2 is surface flattening, and type 3 is based upon the cystic translucency. In type 1A, you see a band of sclerosis usually in the medial part. It is in the B is in the central part. Almost most part of the femoral head is involved in type 1C. And surface flattening, diffuse surface flattening is seen in type 2. These are all radiological classification. And type 3, based upon the cystic translucency, it is central and this is peripheral. Shimizu classification based upon the extent, location, intensity. This is based on this one and the previous one is based on MRI. So in simple to remember, based upon extent, location and intensity of involvement. Subsequently, they graded as grade 1, grade 2 and grade 3. So you remember A, B, C in extent, location is small a, b, c, and intensity is alpha, beta, and lambda. So a is less than 1/4, and b is more than 1/4, but less than half. And c is more than half involvement, extent of involvement. Location it is almost in the inframedial. This is in the center, almost part of the familiar dissemination. More than 2/3 is involved. Intensity, it is high intense in case of alpha. Beta is medium and low intense in case of gamma. And the grader is restricted to medial part as grade 1 and occupies half to 2/3 of the weight bearing surface is grade 2 and more than 2/3 of weight bearing surface as grade 3. And this is another classification by Takori. They defined as two groups, group 1 and group 2. Group 1, the fat intensity signal is confined only to the anterosuperior part of the head, but does not extend beyond. But in group 2, it was subdivided into B, C and D. In B, just a posterior part of the head is involved, and type C is occupy the most of the posterior half, and type D is larger part of involvement than the type C. So Steinberg classification is more like the ARCO staging. So normal asymptomatic seen in stage 0, stage 1 only in abnormal in bone scan, and this is subdivided as ABC based upon mild, moderate, severe based upon the involvement. Sclerosis and cyst changes less than 20, 20 to 40 and more than 40 as ABC and subchondral collapse crescent sign. So this stage 3, there also in stage 3 in ARCO staging, ABC less than 15, 15 to 30 and more than 30 and flattening of femoral head, mild, moderate, severe. So less than 15% of the surface involved with less than 2 mm of depression. Flattening of 15 to 30% with a depression of up to 4 mm. With involvement of more than 30% of the surface of femoral head and depression of more than 4 mm of flattening is severe. Flattening of femoral head with joint narrowing with acetabular involvement. It is mild, moderate, severe based upon the extent of involvement. And stage 6 is the advanced degenerative arthritis. So the clinical features usually we encounter usually in the 3rd to 5th decade, very rare in extremes of age. The mean age is usually in the 5th decade, bilateral in 50% of cases. The onset is insidious, pain in the hip with radiating to the thigh or buttock with a painful gait. Signs, there's a decreased range of movement, particularly the flexion internal rotation may be restricted. If secondary OA develops, there is limitation of movements in all range of movement. Because there's only minimal destruction of it with the deformity, there'll be minimal shortening seen in case of AVN. The classical sectoral sign, which we clinically can be demonstrated in AVN. Sectoral sign to remember, the range of internal rotation is less in hip flexion than in extension. So the internal rotation, when you do an internal rotation, it will be less in flexion than in extension. And the log rolling may also elicit pain. This is possible only when there is an active capsular sinusitis, usually in stage 1 or stage 2A. X-ray, must you have to do an AP and frog leg lateral view, because AP we cannot make anything. X-ray feature is made out only by 2 to 3 months after the initial insult. As discussed, all the radiological signs should be looked in a X-ray. So you see, if it's a bilateral hip with involvement of the femoral head and bilaterally with cystic changes with subsequent sclerosis. And this is the crescent sign, the subchondral thin radiant translucency line seen in the subchondral region. And subsequently, patient weight base, this crescent sign on the level of the weight bearing, it can end up in the step sign. And next, you have the flattening of the femoral head and subchondral collapse. And This is the stage 5, severe destruction of the femoral head with articular involvement, narrowing of the joint space. This you need to know about. This was something new when I started preparing. Only I came to know about this necrotic angle of Kerbal. It's a combined necrotic angle used to quantify the lesion. I read it the first time. So you have to take a AP and lateral view. So mark center of the head, mark a line in the center of the femoral head, and draw two lines along the borders of the lesion. So this angle in AP and lateral, this combined angle forms the necrotic angle of Kerbal. So these are a few examples. Hello. Sir, சொல்லுங்க சார்.
ஒண்ணுல ஒரு ஆறு மணி வாக்கில் வரட்டுமா? ஹலோ,
சொல்லுங்க சார்.
ஒரு ஆறு மணி வாக்கில் வரட்டுங்களா? ஒரு சின்ன மீட்டிங், முடிச்சுட்டு வந்துட்டுமா?
சரி சார், நான் கண்டினியூ பண்ணட்டுமா? ஹலோ,
இல்ல சார், நீங்க கண்டினியூ பண்ணுங்க சார். ஆக்சுவலா வேற கிராஸ் டாக், நீங்க கண்டினியூ பண்ணுங்க.
அது டெரன்ஸோட வாய்ஸ் மாதிரி இருந்துச்சுங்க அது.
சார் இல்ல சார், நீங்க கண்டினியூ.
So this necrotic angle, the combined necrotic angle, is used to quantify the size of the lesion. So they came out as a small, medium and large. So small is 160 degree or less, medium is 161 to 199 degree, and large 200 or more. CT scan, it is usually useful in case to differentiate from a pre-collapse from early collapse, but it has only less sensitivity of only 55%. So this is a picture where there is showing a clumping and distortion. See this asterisk sign, this is the area of the cell death, and this is a low density sign where there is a osteoblastic activity going on. See the difference. And this is another view where there is an anterior and posterior, there are osteophyte with narrowing of joint space with juxta-articular sclerosis. MRI, the most sensitive tool to diagnose AVN, is to make an earliest diagnosis than a bone scan. MRI is the sensitive tool to describe the size of the lesion, and it's useful to estimate the stage. It has got high sensitivity and specificity with an accuracy of 94%. It appears as a low intensity signal in T1 image and high intensity in still image. I'll show you later. And you have the double line appearance in T2 image, where you demarcate between an ischemic and a non-ischemic zone. The MRI is a method of investigation of choice to determine the exact stage and pathological process, and where you can plan for the treatment also. So this is a T1 weighted image. The subcontral changes in the anterosuperior part of the femoral head with a single line of density. So this single line of density demarcating between a normal and ischemic zone. And this is another T2 weighted image, where there's a double line seen. So double line seen between the ischemic and non-ischemic part. So this is another, there's a decreased T1 signal on the cut section. So decreased T1 signal seen in the necrotic segment of femoral head, and increased uptake with a focal central low intensity signal. And this is the double density. This is so this was one patient who came with a hip pain, right hip pain. On X-ray, it was normal. So the patient have persistent hip pain. He was given analgesic and bed rest, but he couldn't tolerate hip pain. So he subjected to MRI. An MRI evaluation, you can make out the crescent sign and the step sign. Usually the step sign is very well encountered in the lateral view in X-ray. See, this is the crescent sign. MRI, you can make out the step sign and crescent sign as early, because X-ray, it takes time. Then next is the bone scan. It's an early diagnosis, but only next to MRI. Usually, technetium 99 sulfur colloid is used. Early stages shows hot spot, and late stages have a donut of it. Just you remember a donut with a chocolate in the center and the ring outside. Donut appearance in late stages. Other imaging studies for remembrance purpose is strontium 87, technetium 99, sodium 24 radioisotopes, and radioactive phosphorus, and sometimes arteriography is used. This is only theoretical. So this is the best. Hello. Sir, proceed pannikalam sir.
Proceed pannunga, no problem.
Sorry, sir.
Voice.
Treatment part, there's no particular treatment to arrest the stages of AVN. Once, when it starts from stage one, it can either go for repair and revascularization, or it can end up in deformity. So it can be a conservative or it can be surgical. So conservative, I like all the PGs to remember this one. Bed rest, initial bed rest with analgesics and continuous traction. But there is no proper study where how long you need to give bed rest and how long you need to give traction analgesic, because few studies up to 3 weeks, up to 6 weeks, because after 6 weeks, the patient again, when he starts weight bearing, he can end up in next stage. So non-weight bearing, they have no effect on the final outcome. Drugs, these drugs are used only in non-traumatic cases, in pre-collapse, or in case of asymptomatic and silent hip, where you found out AVN in one hip and the other hip is silent. In these patients, you can give certain drugs. Only when these etiological factors fit in, patients can be treated with statins in hyperlipidemic states and prostacycline derivative, iloprost, only in case of idiopathic avascular necrosis, and enoxaparin of up to 60 mg per day for 12 weeks in hyperfibrinolytic cases, and alendronate 75 mg per day for 25 weeks, which inhibit the mature osteoclastic activity so that the patient will not proceed to the next phase or deformity phase, that decreases the osteoclastic activity. Extracorporeal shortwave therapy, pulsed electromagnetic field therapy, it gives controls the local inflammation and promotes neovascularization. And hyperbaric oxygen, we give about up to about 100% of oxygen. It induces angiogenesis, improves the oxygen supply to the dead bone in the femoral head. It reduces the bone marrow pressure. Surgical treatment. These are the options available for AVN. For each and every stage, the surgical treatment should be modulated. So patient with stage one, you cannot directly go for a totally pathroplasty in a young male. Like that, if in a case of about 50 with stage four, you cannot go for cord decompression. So for that stage, that treatment is ideally indicated. Cord decompression. Cord decompression is usually indicated in stage 1 and 2A lesions. Usually in case of a small central lesion in young non-obese individual, but they should not be on steroids, because if they are on steroids, the cord decompression is also going to fail, because encountered the fat globules obstructing the fat, causing emboli and causing the arterial occlusion. It relieves pain in 75% of cases. The cord decompression, the main thing in cord decompression is by creeping substitution to the necrotic area. So you have to identify the necrotic part in AP, a lateral view in C-arm, and then you have to decompress the part. So the necrotic part is removed, and from the normal the zone, the new bone cells creep to the necrotic area, but it's not useful in post-traumatic cases. It is a very, it's a percutaneous technique. Either you can go by a conventional core decompression, the DHS guide wire decompression, triple reamer with the DHS can be used, or you can use a multiple drilling. 3mm drill bits are commonly used to avoid breakage. So these are the flue sites. Identify the necrotic segment in AP and lateral view. See, this is AP and lateral view, and this is the DHS guide is used to decompress the necrotic part. Advantages: with decompression of the rigid intraosseous chamber, it improves the vascularity and it can prevent the further ischemic episode. Bone grafting. Usually bone grafting is not done as an isolated procedure. It is usually combined with core decompression. Core decompression with bone grafting, and there are few studies where the electrical stimulation has been done to improve the blood supply to the affected part, but it's less beneficial. Core decompression with non-vascularized graft, bone decompression with the vascularized graft been used for stage 1 and 2 with add-on with muscle pedicle graft. And also this bone grafting can be done by lateral core track and by trapdoor technique, and also by femoral neck, creating a window in the femoral neck, anterior part of femoral neck, and you put some cancellous bone chips. Other grafting methods: Ganji in his study, he aspirated the bone marrow content from the iliac crest and he injected into the decompressed part, and used bone morphogenic protein. But now recently PRP can also be used. There's a study where PRP also has been used. So identify the AP and lateral view in C-arm. So this is a small percutaneous technique. So it's identifying the lateral view, the bone marrow, the BMP from the iliac crest is aspirated and it's been injected into the decompressed part. Next is the non-vascularized graft. Femister, he described this technique used for stage 1 and 2, but this doesn't have of much value, but usually is combined with core decompression. So this is a picture from the Campbell where the necrotic part has been identified, area has been core decompressed, and the fibular stud graft, non-vascularized fibular graft, structural graft has been inserted into the decompressed part. But main thing you have to remember that the diameter of the decompressed part and this, it should be 2 to 3 millimeter more. That core decompression part, it should be more to fit in this graft. Otherwise, you will have a struggle in the theater to put in the graft. So this is the stage 2A where a cortical stud graft has been inserted. This is a pre-op picture where there is a deformed femoral head and cortical stud graft has been used in staged phase. I think it was, I don't remember, 3 months or 6 months duration. See the amount of revascularization in the right side than in the left side. And porous tantalum rods have also been used, because instead of using a cortical stud graft, this acts as a structural and osteoconduction property. It's core decompressed and tantalum rods have been inserted, and see the femoral head shape has been maintained. Vascularized fibular graft. think we have done two cases here in KMC, aspirates fibrograft. The prerequisite must be the age of the patient should be less than 50% without collapse. Good result up to 90% has been seen. It decompresses the femoral head. We can excise the sequestrum. So this is a picture from the Campbell where the patient lateral decubitus position, ipsilateral side, the patient lateral decubitus position, the leg is painted and draped, and you remove the middle part about 13 centimeter of the fibula with peroneal artery and peroneal vein, leaving the proximal 10 centimeter and distal up to 10 to 13 centimeter of fibula is left for the stability of the ankle joint, and this graft is removed along with the periosteum. So already you have co-decompressed the femoral head. So before inserting the vascularized graft, you have to take some cancellous bone chips, usually taken from the trochanteric crest. So you take some cancellous bone chips and you place it there before inserting the vascularized graft. This vascularized graft, the peroneal artery and peroneal vein, is being, these are the donor and the recipient is the femoral artery and femoral vein. And this procedure is usually combined with the plastic surgeon. We did two cases combined with the plastic surgeon and both the cases were doing well. Up to stage two, it can be done. And this is another technique where light bulb procedure has been done. You create, you expose, anteriorly you expose the femoral neck and make a flap so that you can see the necrotic part. Because when you make a window in the femoral head, when you make a window in the femoral head, there's a chance of fracture of the head or neck. So away from the head, you have to make a window and you have to remove the necrotic segment. The another advantage is that you can avoid the cartilaginous injury. So you can place some cancellous bone chips and close the defect. So next is the trapdoor technique. Trapdoor technique is you have to perform a GAN safe surgical dislocation. The femoral head is dislocated and a trapdoor is the diseased part of the subchondral bone is visualized and a small trapdoor is created in the femoral head along the articular cartilage and the necrotic part is debrided and the cancerous bone chips are packed inside. The advantage is direct evaluation, but it needs most precise technique. The high chances of injury to cartilage is seen. The picture from the Campbell, see this is a trapdoor technique where there is a window is made at the anterior part of the neck. And muscle pedicle bone graft. Usually quadratus femoris has been used by posterior approach. Is useful in stage 1 and 2. And Bucks, and these are named procedures. Mayer's procedure, they use quadratus femoris. Bakshi, they used tensor facial ata, but this is by anterior approach. Next is the osteo. These are all the bone conserving procedures. Osteotomies. Osteotomy, the choosing the patient is very ideal. The patient should not be on steroids. There should be minimal OA change with no loss of joint space or acetabular involvement. And there should be small necrotic angle should be less than 160. And the lesion should be small and medium sized lesion within 30 degree of head involved. And it's usually in young patient. But the main disadvantage is it's technically demanding and it needs more experience. But the problem is the conversion to THR later is difficult. There are two types, transtrochanteric rotational osteotomy and intertrochanteric varus or valgus osteotomy. So the main biomechanic of this osteotomy is the necrotic part of the bone is rotated from the weight-bearing surface and is replaced by the healthy bone. It reduces the venous hypertension and decreases the intramedullary pressure. But you should be very careful that the vascular supply of that part should not be altered. If that is compromised, then there is no use of doing this rotational osteotomy. Sukhoika first described in 1978 this transtrochanteric rotational osteotomy. Ideal candidate is age of less than 55 years, less than 30 degree of head involved. So this method is by oleus incision, the greater trochanter is osteotomized, first step. And next you have to transect the short posteriorly short external rotators and quadratus femoris without damaging the medial circumflex femoral artery posteriorly. And the capsule is incised circumferentially from above the acetabulum down to allow the adequate rotation of the femoral head. The first the osteotomy cut is made at the trochanteric level, trochanteric crest level, 10 millimeter distal to the trochanteric crest. This cut should be perpendicular to the neck. This should not be compromised. It should be perpendicular to the femoral neck. And it should be towards the lesser trochanter. The second cut is made in the upper margin of the lesser trochanter. And before rotating, the iliopsoas is transected and two pins has been inserted, one in the proximal and other in the distal fragments. Anterior rotation of up to more than 70 degree of anterior rotation is possible in this technique, and this is fixed with cancellous screw. This picture I took it from the internet, and this patient with an AVN where they did a rotational osteotomy and fixed with the cancellous screw. See the amount of revascularization even after the implant removal. This is I think it was 7 years follow-up. Other osteotomies are flexion osteotomy, extension osteotomy. Everything is done at the level of intertrochanteric level with varus or valgus osteotomy. But this can be done in stage 2 and stage 3 AVN. But to remember always these type of osteotomies to be done with head involvement less than only 30% of head involved. Sometimes valgus extension osteotomy combined with curettage and bone grafting has been also advocated by Shayer and Jakim. So this is a valgus osteotomy with bone grafting. See the good amount of revascularization. This was a 5-year study. This was another case of varus osteotomy. See the main principle behind the osteotomy is you shift the weight-bearing portion. The affected weight-bearing portion, the dome is shifted. So they release the stress on the necrotic part. And this is another case where a trochanteric osteotomy is, intertrochanteric osteotomy is done with varus. See good amount of remodeling there in the femoral head. And this is another procedure, Birmingham hip resurfacing. Actually, when it came, it was a very good procedure in case of young, and it can be used in stage 3 and even in stage 4 AVN. This is ideal treatment. It can be used in head involvement of more than 30% because it has a lot of advantage. Because a 20-30 year old male with AVN, this was an ideal procedure. Easy for revision, less bone is removed, less chance of hip dislocation, and the walking pattern is near normal because you maintain the most part of the neck, only the diseased part of the head is removed. And it got few advantage because we should be very careful that there is more chance of neck fracture and metal ion exit. That is why it became less popular, because initially it was highly popular hip Birmingham hip resurfacing. And this is the gold standard treatment, totally arthroplasty, excellent pain relief and good functional outcome in case of stage 4 AVN. So to categorize, you need to remember, so patient in which stage you want to give what part of treatment, because you're completing your course, you have to identify. For stage 1, ending up in THR is not necessary. You can go for core decompression, you can wait, core decompression with grafting, you can wait, watch, see how he progresses and how you are able to retain his normal, his hip, his head, and later you can plan for totally arthroplasty. At the same time, with the patient of 50, 55 years with stage 4, don't go for core decompression. At that stage, we need to plan for totally arthroplasty. So categorize the stage and go for ideal treatment for the patient, for the disease pertaining. So carry home message is, most common cause is idiopathic. Steroid, the peak dose is more important than the duration. The peak dose, the higher the dose, more chances of AVN. Fracture neck of femur, displaced and mal-reduced fracture has high chances of AVN. Once necrosis occurs, the changes are irreversible. MRI is the gold standard diagnostic tool to diagnose AVN, accuracy of up to 94%. There's no role of conservative treatment. But if the examiners ask, do you know anything about the conservative treatment pertaining to your case, you can tell. But otherwise, in theory part, you can mention all the mode of modalities what we have discussed in conservative treatment. And early diagnosis, and try to preserve the joint as much as possible for a better prognosis. Keep a hip replacement, totally replacement, as a log resort, because hip replacement in a younger group gives a, or is a, because he can end up in revision procedures. So delay the THR. Results of replacement are poor in younger than the older age group. Thank you. Hello.
Magesh. Hello.
Sir.
நீங்க screen sharing இது பண்ணிறீங்களா? இருக்கட்டுமா?
எடுத்துறேன் சார்.
Okay. So thank you Mahesh. Thank you. I think it was I think you've covered everything, but it's enough, more than enough. அதான் சொல்ற மாதிரி, what they say is when you speak, just enough for the skirt to cover everything, and it should not be long also. So அந்த மாதிரி நீங்க, you just covered everything and you've given every information to the postgraduate. And AVN is a very important topic, because it would look easy, but there can be a lot of questions in the exam which will confuse you. It is basically very easy when you understand the classification, as he said. That is why again and again he mentioned the pathology, etiopathogenesis, classification, x-ray finding is very important in as with respect to the AVN. And then the treatment part is very simple. Plus you don't have many options in AVN. Either you have a decompression or you have a replacement. Osteotomies generally are not being done now. So whether to choose between decompression or totally replacement, I think that will be the option. As far as treatment part, there will not be much confusion in the exam. But in classification, x-ray findings and etiopathogenesis, I think if you know all that, I think it is pretty easy. And Ram Prasad, you are here? Few of them, I think, lost connection. And one more thing just want to mention was stage zero. Stage zero means always, the patient comes with a right hip pain and he's got an AVN in the right hip, it means the left hip is in stage zero. The opposite hip, which seems to be normal in x-ray, is supposed to be in stage zero. I think that is why when you call, you have stage zero. the stage zero might be a little confusing. Every hip will have a stage zero, but when the opposite hip, when somebody presents with pain, the opposite hip is always said to be in stage zero. Okay, so I think that should be the Agni and the other PGs. I think you'll have a lot of doubts in this AVN. I think if we can open it for discussion.
வரதராஜன் சரியா? அப்புறம் கீ வந்து எங்க சீஃப் போய் திருத்தும் போது கீ வந்து அதுக்கு 5 மார்க் கொடுத்திருந்தாங்க. 5 மார்க் எப்படி கொடுத்திருந்தாங்கன்னா 3x5 போட்டிருந்தாங்க. அதாவது 3 கிளாசிபிகேஷனா நீ எழுதணும்.
ஓகே
சரியா?
ஓகே சார்.
இதுல வந்து என்னன்னா வந்து இந்த ஃபிக்கட் அண்ட் அலர்ட் மஸ்ட்.
ஓகே சார்.
அப்புறம் வந்து அந்த ஆர்கோ ஸ்டேஜிங்கும் அந்த ஸ்டீன்பர்க்கு ரெண்டும் கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒண்ணுதான்.
ஓகே சார்.
சரியா? அப்புறம் அந்த சின்ன சின்ன கிளாசிபிகேஷன் நீ ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கலாம். அந்த ஷிமுஜி கிளாசிபிகேஷன் எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் லொகேஷன் அண்ட் அந்த இன்வால்வ்மென்ட் வந்து அது தெரியிறதுக்கு அது ஈஸியர் ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கலாம்.
ஓகே.
சோ ஒரு 3 கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் வரைக்கும் நீ கண்டிப்பா தெரிஞ்சே ஆகணும்.
ஓகே.
பிக் அண்ட் அலர்ட் வந்து உனக்கு லைஃப் லாங் வந்து தெரிஞ்சிக்க வேண்டியது. மத்தபடி தியரிட்டிகல் பார்ட். இது பிக் அண்ட் அலர்ட் தெரிஞ்சாதான் வந்து நீ பிராக்டிகலுக்கு இல் பி மோர் யூஸ்ஃபுல் வேர் யூ கேன் ஃபிட் பேஸ்ட் அப்பான் தி எக்ஸ்ரே யூ கேன் ஃபிட் வேர் இட் suits and based upon the and the classification that you can go for treatment.
Okay sir. Sir, another question.
Le, Varadarajan, நீ கேட்ட கேள்விக்கு வந்து சார் சொன்ன மாதிரி classification is important. Okay. You learn 2 classifications in AVN. Okay. One is wicket and alert, there's no doubt about that. Okay. So other 2 classifications, ARCO is very important because recent classifications are based on ARCO. Your Steinberg okay. and ARCO are very, very similar. See, உனக்கு வந்து ஒரு ஏவியன் வந்துருச்சுன்னா ஏவியன்ல டயக்னோசிஸ்ல ப்ராப்ளமே இருக்காது. ஜென்ரலி யூ நாட் ஹேவ் எனி ப்ராப்ளம். ஓகே. எக்ஸெப்ட் இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு ஷோ செக்டோரல் சைன், இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு டெமோன்ஸ்ட்ரேட் செக்டோரல் சைன், தே வில் டெஃபினெட்லி அக்செப்ட். ஈவன் அதர்வைஸ் யூ வில் ரூல் அவுட் ஆல் தி அதர் ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் யூ கேன் சே இட் இஸ் அன் ஏவாஸ்குலர் நெக்ரோசிஸ். ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் ஏவாஸ்குலர் நெக்ரோசிஸ் வந்துருச்சுன்னா கிளாசிபிகேஷன் கண்டிப்பாக கேட்பாங்க. ஸோ ரெண்டு கிளாசிபிகேஷன் நல்லா தரவ படிச்சுக்கோ. ஒன் இஸ் விக்கெட் அண்ட் அலர்ட், அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்டீன்பர்க்ஸ். ஸ்டீன்பர்க்ஸ் ஆர் ஆர்கோ.
சொல்லுங்க.
கட் ஆயிடுச்சா?
சொல்லுப்பா.
சார் சார், வெதர் கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் ஹேஸ் எ ரோல் இன் ஸ்டீராய்டு இன்டியூஸ்டு ஏவியன் ஆர் நாட் சார்?
இல்லை, ஸ்டீராய்டு இன்டியூஸ்டு ஏவியனில் வந்து இட்ஸ் நாட் தட் மச் ஆஃப் யூஸ். கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் வந்து நான் ட்ராமா கேசஸ் யூஸ் பண்ண முடியாது.
ஓகே சார்.
பிகாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி வந்து தட்ஸ் அன் இன்சல்ட் இன் ஸ்டீராய்டு இன்டியூஸ் கேஸ். நீ கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷ் பண்ணால் தட்ஸ் ஹை சான்சஸ் ஆஃப் தே ஐடியல் கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் மஸ்ட் பி கம்பைன்டு வித் போன் கிராஃப்டிங் ப்ரொசீஜர். பண்ணக்கூடாதுன்னு கிடையாது, பண்ணலாம். பட் நான் வந்து முதல்ல ஒரு 8 வருஷம் முன்னாடியில் வெறும் கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் மட்டும் பண்ணேன். ஒரு 2-3 பேஷண்ட் வெறும் கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் பண்ணிட்டு அப்புறம் விட்டுட்டேன். தென் ஒன்லி ஐ கேம் டு நோ தட் ஸ்டார்டட் இன்ஜெக்டிங் இந்த இலியாக்ரஸ்லேருந்து ஆஸ்பிரேட்டட் போன் மேரோ கண்டென்ட் அண்ட் இன்ஜெக்டர். ஸோ பேஷண்ட் வாஸ் டூயிங் வெல் அப் டு 4-5 இயர்ஸ்.
Okay.
So never stop alone with the core decompression. Core decompression must be combined with any type of bone marrow injection. Illana vandu you go for a bone graft, either a structural graft or a vascularized graft. Bone core decompression mattum pattadu.
Okay, we did a case in KMC sir. For a case of a steroid induced AVN, we did it.
See, core decompression, Mageshan, what is the, look, Varadarajan, one minute. What is the level of evidence for stem cell treatment in avascular necrosis? Because stem cell, when they, LRM, a lot of people have started using stem cell. No, it's a, though it's a costly procedure. So core decompression stem cell, how, what are the studies and how it improves the outcome of your decompression?
So stem cell is same, that it increases the newborn formation. Because the mesenchymal, the primitive mesenchymal cells induces the osteoblastic activity the same way as PRP. This stem cells also induces more amount of new bone cells. There are studies are there.
For the later, recent advances are definitely stem cell in neovascular necrosis and treatment of stem cell on the definitely kepang. We'll just go through that also. Varadarajan, Kelama, I wanted to ask something.
Sir, one last question, sir.
Kelama.
Sir, why even is common in HIV, sir?
HIV patient, ah?
Yes, sir.
HIV, hello?
Yes, sir, yes, I'm on.
வரதராஜன் வந்து ஹெச்ஐவி பேஷண்ட் மட்டும் இந்த காமனா
இல்லை சார் மற்றதுக்கெல்லாம் ஈட்டியாலஜி சொல்லிட்டீங்க சார் ஹெச்ஐவிக்கு என்ன
ஹெச்ஐவிக்கு நான் தேடி பார்த்தேன் ஆக்சுவலி டு பி ஃப்ரங்க் வந்து ஹெச்ஐவிக்கு வந்து ஐ குடன் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி ஈட்டியாலஜி எல்லாமே வந்து அந்த
இருக்கு சார் ஹெச்ஐவி கரெக்டான இது இல்லைன்னு கேட்டுக்கிறேன்
சார் ஆமா ஹெச்ஐவிக்கு இல்ல பட் அந்த விஸ்கஸ் சைக்கிள் வந்து நீ ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்க எதுலயோ ஒன்று ஃபிட் ஆகும் அந்த விஸ்கஸ் சைக்கிள் இருக்கு பாத்தியா ஸோ த விஸ்கஸ் சைக்கிள் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் வேர் ஆல் தி காசஸ் ஃபிட்ஸ் இன்
ஓகே சார் சரிங்க சார் ஓகே
like even I don't know Varadarajan why it is common in HIV
I couldn't find out
maybe yes, we'll find out
or rendu mu time neenga HIV test panninga sir but ana adu correctly ET pathogen
irukku maybe some drug induced because of HIV lot of they take lot of antiviral retroviral drugs adanal irukalam we don't know seriya even I don't know really I don't know
okay
other questions ma I think this is a very important topic idu in exam nariya question idu ketukitte irupanga diagnosis problem irukadhu
சார் குட் ஈவினிங் சார் கபிலன்
யா கேளு கேளு கபிலன்
கேளு
சார் எனக்கு ஒரு சார் ஒரு யங் பேஷண்ட் 30-25 மேல் சார் ஸ்டேஜ் 3 ஏவிஎம் சார் தியரிட்டிக்கலா என்ன ஆன்சர் பண்ணணும் என்ன ப்ரொசீஜர் பண்ணுவீங்க கேட்டா தியரிட்டிக்கலா என்ன சொல்லணும் பிராக்டிக்கலா என்ன சொல்லணும் சார்
சி தியரிட்டிக்கலா வந்து ஸ்டேஜ் 3 ஏவிஎம் இன் 35 இயர் ஓல் மேல் சோ யூ டேக் an MRI
ஓகே சார்
டேக் an MRI see the amount of the involvement ஸோ அதில் வந்து மைல்ட் மாட்ரேட் சிவியர்னு பாருங்க ஸோ சிவியர்னு போயிடுச்சுன்னா யூ கேன் நாட் கோ ஃபார் கோ டீகம்ப்ரெஷன் அண்ட் போன் கிராஃப்டிங் இட்ஸ் மைல்ட் அப் டு மாட்ரேட் வரைக்கும் யூ கேன் கோ ஃபார் கோ டீகம்ப்ரெஷன் அண்ட் இன் பர்டிகுலர் யூ ஹேவ் டு கோ ஃபார் அ வாஸ்குலரைஸ் ஃபிப்ரிலோகிராஃப்ட் பிகாஸ் அந்த வாஸ்குலரைஸ் ஃபிப்ரிலோகிராஃப்ட் இஸ் கிளினிக்கலி ப்ரூவன் வேர் இட் ஹஸ் காட் அ குட் ப்ரொக்னோசிஸ் As far as possible, the head preserving procedure was good than the head removal.
Now, can I answer that question, Mahesh? Shall I answer that question?
Sure, sir.
La, Prabhu, you get a call. You know, it's a very good question actually. But in an exam point of view, la, whatever you say, if you are able to justify your answer again, I'm telling this point. You know, the replacement, so you could escape by now. Tell me, Kapa, you know, 30-year-old, you want to operate, you want to do replacement, sir. He has gone to stage 3. There's no question of doing a core decompression on this patient. He will not improve. But I will discuss with the patient. But I will always give him an option of staying in stage decompression, which might not help him. If he says he is not willing, he's willing for only one surgery, he wants a very active life, then I will go for total hip replacement. So, DA soldier, stage 3 in soldier, you are given the justification. Stage 2A varikum, Mahesh Ram purutha varikum, bookla purutha varikum, stage 2A purutha varikum, stage the core decompression, there is no doubt. Stage 2B poishna, there is a subchondral collapse now, or there is a subchondral fractures, type C, or perina crescent sign vandiruchu. So now it is not going to improve. Still, this stage is a borderline stage where you might take the option of stage core decompression or total hip replacement. Stage 3 poiruchu appadina, flattening, head to flatten aayiruchu. Head to once it flattens, it is not going to improve. He is going to anyway end up in a, arthritis. So in that case, when he comes with pain, then you can always push him to total hip replacement or try to, you will tell, say it is already flattened. I want to give him some more time, maybe 6 months, 1 year, or if he is willing for surgery, I'll go and I do a total hip replacement. So if you are able to justify your answer, any examiner will accept. This is only a scientific reasoning. Exam la vandu, ni scientific reason out pandriya. Whether you unnoda findings vechi unnala diagnose panna mudiyada unno diagnosis base panni unnala treatment correct ah panna mudiyada ivula dhaan exam la unna check panna poranga so don't worry whatever you say you justify your answer okay
seri
okay vera prabha I think prabha wanted to ask a question
hello
sir solunga sir eppadi irukinga
sir nalla irukken sir
ஒரு கேஸ் பண்ணிருந்தேன் இட்ஸ் ரீசன்ட் ஆர்டிகல் கேம் லைக் தட் என்னன்னா கோ டீகம்ப்ரஷன் ஃபாலோட் பை ஸ்டெம் செல்ஸ் ஆர் பிஆர்பி தென் வி ஹேவ் டு டு தட் பிஸ்பாஸ்மினேட் தெரபி சோ பிஸ்பாஸ்மினேட் இன்ஃபியூஷன் அது பண்ணிட்டு தென் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஸ்டார்ட் அந்த ஃபோர்த் ஜென்ரேஷன் பிஸ்பாஸ்மினேட்ஸ் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாம் சார் அது ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிட்டு தென் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஜென்ரேஷன் அஸ் அ ஓரல் ட்
பட் என்னன்னா நம்ம கவர்மெண்ட் ஹாஸ்பிடல் வர வரும்போது ஸ்டெம் செல் வந்து மேபி இட் இஸ் டூ எக்ஸ்பென்சிவ்
இல்ல ஸ்டெம் செல்ஸ் ஆர் பிஆர்பி சார் தேர் இஸ் ஒன் ஸ்டடி many studies are there
இல்ல கரெக்ட் யூ ஆர்
அண்ட் தே ஹேவ் ட்ராக் யா ஐ காட் தி ஆர்டிகல் फ्रॉम எஸ்ஆர்எம்சி எஸ்ஆர்எம்சி ல வந்து பண்ணிருக்காங்க ஜஸ்ட் ஐ ஃபாலோ தட் கேஸ் சார் 2 இயர்ஸ் ஃபாலோ அப் இருக்கு என்னோட பைலேட்டரலா பண்ண ஐ டிட் தட் கேஸ் அண்ட் எக்ஸலென்ட் ரிசல்ட் கேம் சோ ஜஸ்ட் ஐ வாண்ட் டு ஷேர் தட் இருக்கு சார் அது மாதிரி இருக்கு தி ஸ்டில் ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் தேர்
பட் எக்ஸலென்ட் ரிசல்ட் இட் வில் கிவ் பட் நம்ம எக்ஸாம் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூ கபிலனோட क्वेश्चन வந்து எக்ஸாம் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூல ஸ்டெம் செல்லா நம்ம இங்க சொல்ல முடியாது இல்ல
ஆ எஸ்
அதுக்காக அதனோட அவனோட क्वेश्चन வந்து எக்ஸாம் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூல என்ன சொல்றதுன்னு கேக்குறான்
ஓ அப்பனா டு எஸ் சார் சார் டு ஆட் ஆன் தட் நியூவர் இன்னோவேட்டிவ்னு சொல்லிட்டு கடைசி எழுதும்போது we can add on this point
so how much of stem cell do you inject what is the quantity so how much yes, bone marrow when how stem cell na how do you do that how much of blood you take so when do you take that at the time of surgery sir you take or you take it before itself how do you do that stem cell preparation
sir actually during the surgery itself I had to take sir sir take and one person will come and do but I did only prp sir not stem cells
la so adu pannirken na raja case pannirken stem cell
aha
so okay, stem cell okay. pannirken so it normally what they do is 100 to 120 ml of iliac crest blood they have to harvest you have to harvest yes, 100 to 120 ml so exam la kepanga evlo edupinga appo kepanga pgs is on the 10 ml 20 ml appadina they know you don't know about it so you need to take 80 minimum 80 ml to 120 to 160 ml you have to take
okay okay sir
mahesh actually ram prasad oda connection poiruchan but the last part la mattum connection poiruchan thr sir you want to tell it was a very nice presentation phone panni sonnaru
seri
sir want to connect sir again. one more thing please. Sir sorry sir still see sir still when the osteotomy at exam point of view shall we say still say osteotomy as a as some role appdi sollalama sir suppose for pgs na just kekkuren
illa sir
adha
sir late off la vand osteotomy vand pandradilla
ah yes sir yes sir
osteotomy only theory part da osteotomy
ama kandipa theory points
exam la vandi if any other nama vandu core decompression solran any other option na vandu adutha thr solran do you know any other treatment option for stage 1 2 any other option apart from core decompression and thr thavuth edha theriyuma na adha examiner vandu kekkumbodhu tharalama sollalam
yes sir yes sir only thing vandu future thr will be a difficult one
ama
adhu dhan sir osteotomy the only drawback of osteotomy adhu dhan sir
Sugiyoka osteotomy vandu is historical it has become historical now it is not
historical yes.
but and the word vandu kandipa theriyum
definitely
the old examiners are very fond of that word sugiyoka osteotomy they'll definitely ask you is there any osteotomy you know whether you do it or not do you know on osteotomy nu kepanga sugiyoka derotation I mean complete the rotation osteotomy is important osteotomy which they used to do now it has become agni vaanga agni wanted to ask question vaanga please அக்னிராஜ் வாங்க யூ ஆர் தேர் ஆன் லைன் பா மத்த பிஜிஸோ யூ இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் क्वेश्चन ஜஸ்ட் ஃப்ரீ டு ஆஸ்க் பா இன்னும் யார் ஒன்னு இது பண்ண போறது இல்ல அக்னிராஜ்
சார் கவில இன்னொரு டவுட் இருக்கு சார்
கேளு அதுக்கு தான் இந்த புரோகிராமே
சார் இப்ப பேஷன்ட் பிரசன்டட் அட் ஸ்டேஜ் 3 at 30 இயர்ஸ் சார் பட் ஹி இஸ் நாட் வில்லிங் ஃபார் THR at 35 ஹி கம்ஸ் அட் ஸ்டேஜ் 4 சார் வெதர் இட் ஹட் பீன் ஈஸி யூ டு ஆபரேட் அட் THR at 30 or 35 சார் ஸ்டேஜ் 4 போய்ட்டா THR பண்றது கஷ்டமா சார் எதா டிஃபிகல்ட் இருக்கு மாஸ்டர்
இல்ல அப்படி எல்லாம் இல்லப்பா
சரிங்க சார் انا இது ஒரு
கேக்குறேன் இல்ல ஸ்லைட்லி மோர் டிஃபிகல்ட் அவ்வளவுதான் டோரிம் தாஸ் டேபிள் இதுல வந்து யூ ஹேவ் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் எ வெர்ஜன்
அவுட்கம் ஸ்டேஜ் 3 க்கும் ஸ்டேஜ் 4 க்கும் ஏதாச்சும் மாறுமா சார்
அதாவது யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு டு எ ரீப்ளேஸ்மென்ட் லா தேர் வில் பீ நோ சேஞ்ச்
நீங்க முன்னாடியே வந்திருந்தா இன்னும் நல்லா இருந்திருக்கும் அப்படிங்கற மாதிரி
இல்ல இல்ல இது வந்து நம்ம கார்டியாக் ப்ராப்ளம் மாதிரி கிடையாது இது ரொம்ப அந்த மாதிரி கிடையாது THR எப்போ பண்றதனாலும் யூ கேன் டு இட் சோ தட்ஸ் வாட் ஐம் சேயிங் எனி டைம் யூ கேன் கெட் இட் நோ இஷூ
ஓகே
அக்னி
ஹலோ சார்
வெங்கடேஷ் கேளு
சார்.
வெங்கடேஷ் வாய்ஸ் பிரேக் ஆகுது.
ஹலோ சார், கேக்குதா சார்?
சொல்லுங்க பா. இருக்குல்ல, அது மட்டும்தான் வந்து யூ ஹாவ் டு கிவ் 3 months கேப், பிகாஸ் கோர் டீகம்ப்ரஷன் பண்ணிட்டு யூ மஸ்ட் மேக் த பேஷண்ட் வெயிட் பேர். ஸோ ரைட் ஹிப் பைலாட்டல் ஹிப் இன்வால்வ் ஆயிருக்கு, இது எந்த சிவியர் ஹிப், சப்போஸ் ரைட் சிவியராக இருக்குன்னா அதை ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பண்ணிட்டு வாஸ்குலரைஸ் ஃபிப்ரிலோகிராஃப் பண்ணிட்டு யூ வெயிட் ஃபார் அ பீரியட் ஆஃப் 3 months அண்ட் தென் கோ ஃபார் த அதர் ஹிப். அதுக்கு ஒன்று மட்டும்தான் வந்து இந்த 3 months, மற்றபடி வந்து சேம் சிட்டிங்கை தாராளமாக பண்ணலாம், பண்ணியிருக்கோம்.
Okay.
Magesha, I think there's, I think slightly I differ in this. Is it an authentic statement? Because எனக்கு நான் படிச்ச வரைக்கும் எக்ஸாம்ல கேட்ட வரைக்கும் நார்மலி we don't do bilateral decompression at the same time. Because you cannot allow weight bearing once you do a core decompression. Normally we don't allow weight bearing because we delay weight bearing for at least 6 weeks. Then partial weight bearing and then complete weight bearing only after 12 weeks. So normally they don't do a bilateral decompression at the same time. I think this is what I know. But
sir, adu vandu
latest prepare pannirukinga.
Hello, ma sir. Core decompression with
this is, if you are very sure we'll take it up, or I think we have to just I think verify on this.
Hello, core decompression with vascular graft.
Sir, we can do it sir, but vandu crutch vachi ipo use pannalam sir. We can use that crutch 3.8 4 going adu pannirukalam sir.
மற்றபடி ஸ்டெம் செல்லு, பிஆர்பி, இலியாக்ரஸ் போன் மேரோ ஆஸ்பிரேஷன் இன்ஜெக்ஷன் எல்லாமே சேம் சிட்டிங்ல தாராளமா பண்ணலாம்.
ஓகே ஓகே, ஐ டேக் யுவர் வார்ட், பட் எனிவே ஐ திங்க் வி வில் ஜஸ்ட் வெரிஃபை திஸ்.
ஓகே சார், ஐ வில் செண்ட் ஆர்டிகல் சார், நோ ப்ராப்ளம் சார். இருக்கு சார்,
எக்ஸாம்ல ஆர்டிகல் அக்செப்ட் பண்ண மாட்டாங்க பிரபா,
புக்ல சார் இல்ல சார். சரி ஓகே,
ரொம்ப லேட்டஸ்ட் ஆர்டிகல்ல கோட் பண்ணனா அவங்களுக்கு தெரியும்ல.
ஓகே ஓகே ஓகே,
இல்ல நான் இது டவுட் தான், இட் இஸ் a doubtful because I think that is a very very valid questions from Venkatesh. Very good question. I think we'll definitely check. I'll go by Mahesh Ram's words, but anyway we'll just confirm it. Agni okay. Wanted to ask a question. அவர் உள்ள லைன்ல வர மாட்டேங்கறாரு. I don't know if he's got some
problem. அன்மியூட் ஆக மாட்டீங்க சார்.
ஜோர்டன் அவர் அன்மியூட் பண்ணி மியூட் பண்ணுங்க.
இது அன்மியூட் அன்மியூட் பண்ணுற ஆடியோ டிவைஸ்.
ஏ பா ஜோர்டன், உன்னோட வாய்ஸ் கோயிங் கோயிங் கோயிங்
இல்ல, யூ கேன் கோ, அதுதான் இட் கால்ட் அ சைலண்ட் ஹிப். த சைலண்ட் ஹிப் வந்து ஒரு ஹிப் வந்து சிம்டமேட்டிக், யூ டூ அன் எம்ஆர்ஐ போத் ஹிப்ஸ், அந்த ஹிப் ஸ்டேஜ் ஜீரோ சார் சொன்ன மாதிரி. ஸோ யூ கேன் கோ ஃபார் அ ப்ரொஃபைலாக்டிக் கோ டீகம்ப்ரெஷன் பண்ணலாம்.
மகேஷ் அக்னிராஜோட question வந்து இஸ் தேர் எனி மெடிக்கல் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் ஃபார் ஏவியன், அதான் கேக்குறாரு.
மெடிக்கல் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் தான் போட்டு, மெடிக்கல் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் தான் வந்து பெட் ரெஸ்ட், traction and analgesic based upon the pain. Adukapra you have the drugs, few drugs are there. Drugs vandu iloprost irukku, iloprost ellame vandu idiopathic avian, iloprost, alendronate, apra extra corporeal short wave therapy and பல்ஸ் எலக்ட்ரோமேக்னெட்டிக் தெரபி அண்ட் ஹைப்பர்பாரிக் ஆக்சிஜன். ஐ திங்க் வெதர் சார் கேக்குதான்னு தெரியல.
இல்ல இல்ல அது ஆமாமா நீங்க அப்பவே கிளியரா மென்ஷன் பண்ணிட்டீங்க. நீங்க நீங்க ஐ திங்க் யூ மென்ஷன் வெரி கிளியர்லி. ஹலோ.
பட் மெடிக்கல் மேனேஜ்மென்ட் ஃபார் பிஜிஸ் வந்து மெடிக்கல் மேனேஜ்மென்ட் வந்து ஃபார் ஏவியன் ஸ்டேஜ் 1 ஸ்டேஜ் 2 கிளினிக்கல் டிஸ்கஷன் அப்போ கன்சர்வேட்டிவ் தெரபி அப்படினா நீ பெட் ரெஸ்ட் ட்ராக்ஷன் வேணா சொல்லலாம். அதுக்கு நடுவுல ஐ வில் இன்வெஸ்டிகேட் த கேஸ் ஃபர்தர் எவாலுவேட் த கேஸ் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் த ஸ்டேஜ் அண்ட் ஐ வில் பிளான் அக்கார்டிங்லின்னு சொல்லணும். அங்கே போய் நீ வந்து நான் வில் ஸ்டார்ட் இம் ஆன் அலென்ட்ரனேட் ஐ வில் புட் இம் ஆன் இலோப்ராஸ்லாம் சொல்ல முடியாது. திஸ் இஸ் ஒன்லி ஃபார் தியரட்டிக்கல் பார்ட். இஃப் த எக்ஸாம்னா அ வெரி பர்டிகுலர் தட் யூ நோ அபவுட் எனி ட்ரக்ஸ் விச் கேன் பி யூஸ் ஃபார் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் ஏவியன்னா இதை மென்ஷன் பண்ணுங்க. இல்லைன்னா தேவையில்லாமல் இந்த ட்ரக்ஸ் எல்லாம் சொல்லி டோன்ட் கெட் யுவர் செல்ஃப் ட்ராப்.
ஆனந்த் எட்வென்ச்சர் எங்க எட்வென்ச்சர் அடிக்கடி வரவே மாட்டேங்கறானே. முடிச்சு போய்ட்டான் அவன்.
ஹலோ சார். சரிங்க சார் இருக்கேன்
சார். எட்வென் இருக்கியா
சார்? எட்வென் வந்து ஸ்லீப்பர் செல் மாதிரி இருக்கா சார்?
இல்ல இல்ல எல்லாரும் வந்து உங்க நேம் போடுங்கப்பா. Redmi அதெல்லாம் வேண்டாம்.
எஸ் சார் எஸ் சார்.
ஓகே டோன்ட் ஹைட் யுவர்செல்ஃப் புட் யுவர் நேம் சோ தட்
இது ஃபோன் பேர் வந்து
இல்ல இல்ல அப்புறம் அப்புறம் மாத்து. சோ யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் எனி டவுட்ஸ் ரிகார்டிங் தி சேவியர் ஆனந்த்?
இல்ல சார். சார் கேக்குதா சார்?
பா அஞ்சில ரெண்டு பேர் கேவியன் தான் பா வரோம் எக்ஸாம்ல தெரிஞ்சுங்க நல்லா. சோ மேக் ஷூர் தட் யூ ரீட் யுவர் ஏவியன் வெல். ஹி இஸ் गिवन an entire outline of avascular necrosis. சோ மகேஷ்ரம் என்ன புக் போய் படிக்க சொல்றீங்க? வாட் புக் ஆர் வாட் ரெஃபரன்சஸ் யூ வாண்ட் டு கோ அண்ட் ரீட். சோ வாட் யூ பெர்னா டெல் देम டு வாட் இஸ் யுவர் அட்வைஸ் to which book for them to go and read, because avian is not there in any one particular book.
Amma sir,
naane tell them to go and read whatever the books you have read and referred. I think it will be compared to, it be easier for them to go and do that.
Sir Campbell, Turek and Mercer,
idu moonu poduma? Campbell
idu moonu podu sir pg point of view, because na vandu kittadatta or 7 8 book edutha. ஒரு சிலதெல்லாம் வந்து பிக்சர்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்து நெட்ல இந்த இது பண்ண. பட் தியரிட்டிக்கல் பார்ட் வந்து இந்த மூணு புக் போகுது சார்.
ஓகே ஓகே. அண்ட் ஆர்கோ கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் வந்து இஸ் தி ரீசன்ட் கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் தே டெஃபினட்லி தே வில் ஆஸ்க். அது வந்து ஆர்கோ கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் கண்டிப்பா படிக்கணும். டிக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்ல இட்ஸ் ஒன் பிராக்டிகலி வெரி யூஸ்ஃபுல். மத்ததெல்லாம் ஒண்ணு பெருசா ஒண்ணு ஏவியன் ஒண்ணு பெருசா கிடையாது பா படிக்கிறதுக்கு. இட்ஸ் நாட் வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட் டு கோ
ரைட். தட் இஸ் டிக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்ல மாடிஃபைட் டிக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்ல கிடையாது. விச் ஒன் ஃபாலோ?
அந்த மாடிஃபைட் விக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்லெட் வந்து அந்த ஸ்டேஜ் வந்து எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஒரு ஸ்டேஜ் ஒன்னு ஆட் பண்ணிருப்பாங்க. பட் தட் டசன்ட் மேக் எனி டிஃபரன்ஸ். அப்ப விக்கெட் அண்ட்
ஆர்லெட்டே நம்ம
மாடிஃபைட் படிச்சுக்கோ. ஆல்வேஸ் மாடிஃபை பண்ணது படிச்சு வச்சுக்கோ. இட்ஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் ஈஸி. இஃப் யூ ரீட் விக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்லெட் தென் வாட் எவர் த மாடிஃபிகேஷன் யூ நோ இன் மாடிஃபைட் விக்கெட் அண்ட் ஆர்லெட். சோ இதெல்லாம் வந்து இட்ஸ் நாட் எ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் திங். யூ நோ சம்திங் யூ நோ இட் வெரி வெல் தட்ஸ் ஆல். குணா உனக்கு ஏதாவது க்வெஸ்சன் இருக்கா? இதோ அன்மியூட் ஆயிட்டே இருக்கான் இது.
சரி இல்ல சார் எதுவும் இல்ல சார்.
இல்ல இல்ல உண்டு அன்மியூட் ஆயிட்டே இருக்கு அதான் கேட்டேன். சோ பிரபா எனிதிங்?
ஹலோ. ஆ சார் ஒண்ணல்ல தேர் இஸ் சம் காமன் கன்ஃபியூஷன். வாட் இஸ் செக்டோரல் சைன்? அதுல எந்த மூமெண்ட்ஸ் இன்கிரீஸ் ஆகுது? நார்மலா கொஞ்சம் அது கன்ஃபியூஸ் பண்றாங்க சார் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி டைம்.
இல்ல இல்ல செக்டோரல்
கிளினிக்கலா? கிளினிக்கலா சார் செக்டோரல் சைனா கிளினிக்கலா என்ன பார்ப்பாங்க?
செக்டரல் சைன் தான் பேஷண்ட் வந்து இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன் இருக்குல்ல சார்.
ஆமா
இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன் will be limited. பேஷண்ட் வந்து இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன் you check it in flexion hip in flexion ஏதோ
ஓகே ஓகே.
you check in flexion and you check hip in neutral position. அதுல வந்து there will be variation in amount of internal rotation. That is classical of sectoral sign.
பிரபா செக்டோரல் சைன் இஸ் வெரி சிம்பிள். அதாவது வந்து மகேஷ்ராம் சொன்ன மாதிரி வென் தேர் இஸ் அ ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் ஆஃப் த ஹிப் அண்ட் இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன் இன் ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் தேர் வில் பி மோர் இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன். அவ்வளோதான். பிகாஸ் தி இலியோஃபெமரல் லிகமெண்ட்ஸ் வில் பி ரிலாக்ஸ்ட் இன் ஃப்ளெக்ஷன். வேரஸ் இன் எக்ஸ்டென்ஷன் தி இலியோஃபெமரல் லிகமெண்ட்ஸ் வில் பி வெரி டாக்ட் அண்ட் இட் வில் நாட் அலவ் தி இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன். ஸோ நார்மலி வென் நார்மல் ஹிப் வென் யூ டூ ஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அண்ட் யூ ரொட்டேட் யூ வில் கெட் மோர் இன்டர்னல் ரொட்டேஷன் அண்ட் தென் when the hip is in extension. But in sectoral sign, what happens is the internal rotation and flexion will be restricted. whereas the internal rotation extension will be slightly more. So that is, so ipo 30 degrees ipo flex pandra normal hip left right side avn irukku left side la vandu you check, okay, you get 30 degrees of internal rotation in flexion and 20 degrees of internal rotation in extension, suppose that is normal hip. When you do in avn, it will be 20 degrees of internal rotation in extension and it can be 20 degrees or less. So 30 degrees la irundha 5 degree koranja kuda ang internal rotation korayudu, so that is also called as sectoral slip. It need not be always lesser than what it is in extension, but normal la irukka kudi internal rotation opposite side out in the side koranjala, it means it is sectoral slip. I think that itself is a huge big topic. I think nama and the question answer sessions adhi kadasiya vechikalam and and the time la I think about all the clinical aspects I think we can cover. So Magesh, thanks Magesh.
Okay sir,
wonderful presentation. I think you nariya questions vandha, I think lot of people want to know a lot about avian avascular necrosis. I think you covered excellently well, especially the etiopathogenesis, which every PD has to know. Radiology, whatever is there you have covered, whatever the classification, everything you have given, and the treatment options also, everything you have clearly explained. So idu vandu just oru vaadi idu go through pannite, then you go and read the exam, because 2 out of 5 cases will definitely be avian. So avian again and again, your bread and butter. Even if you go outside, then the question na patient e unna kepanga sir, stem cell podlama, PRP podlama, yen enakku 35 vayasula THR pandringa, THR panninga enakku enna hip neenga poda poringa, enakku ceramic use panna poringla illana vandu vera enna hip use panna poringa. So all, so many questions the patient will ask you, because the avascular necrosis patient, most of the time I've seen are very very educated patients. They will know more than you. A patient came to me with fricated nodular classification. Avan tarava irundha fricated nodular classification la avan ella hip.
Hello,
yes sir.
Hello, illa nenu poiduchinga vera onnum illa, sorry. Hello, battery laptop la na battery teendruchu. So and the classification one is very important sometimes, so make sure that you read everything. Is given a wonderful Karina is covered completely. So we thank him, Magesh, thank you so much.
Neenga
rendu class la mudikkanum nadacha ore class la mudichitinga.
Aama
so so thank you so much, and Monday we will meet again for listhesis class. Spondylolisthesis, okay. Note pannikko.
Okay sir.
So Monday will be a spondylolisthesis, that will be by Dr. Sudhir. Seriya, followed by all femur topics, the spine topics, hip topics will be covered after listhesis.